company become digital? Yes, and it has to, otherwise the company will literally die. Actually, almost all the industries are facing the digital revolution and are massively disrupted. Travel, retail, banking, insurance, media, telecommunications, all of them have to reinvent themselves to stay in the race. On top of that, the boundaries between what is digital and not digital are getting more and more blurry. Traditional brick-and-mortar companies are trying to get more digital. The French retail company Monoprix just acquired the shoe retail platform Sarenza. Nike just bought the data analytics company Zodiac. And at the same time, the pure players are trying to invest massively in brick-and-mortar assets. Amazon with Whole Foods, Google with Walmart, and they are opening physical stores. The hospitality industry is a good example of this digital trend. Our hotel has just celebrated last November its 50th anniversary. It belongs to a very traditional brick-and-mortar industry. And at the same time, it's also embodying a striking paradox. You will always need to experience your stay, to enjoy the beauty of the lobby, to taste the flavor of your breakfast and your scrambled eggs. Yet, the hospitality industry is probably one of the most disruptive businesses in the world, facing not one, but two battlefields. One battlefield, the traditional one, with all our well-known competitors, but also the digital battlefield, with new competitors, pure players, collaborative platform, sharing economy actors, and they are setting up very aggressive competition. So what should we do? And the question would rather be, how can a non-digital company become digital? Because obviously it has to become digital, and become digital fast. In Accor, the digitalization process started quite early in 2014 with the launch of the digital plan. The idea was to digitalize the customer experience, but also to reinforce the IT infrastructure, considering the exponential growth of the IT solicitation, looking at the hospitality market becoming more and more online. Just to give you an idea, between 2007 and 2017, the ratio of books to books, i.e. the number of IT requests needed to finalize a booking, evolved from an average of 20 to over 1,000 just to finalize one booking. Already 40% of the transactions are done online. People will get social more and more online, and they will indeed log in, use more and more their device mobile for their daily activities. For the past 4 years, under Sebastian Bazin leadership, digitalization process has also met in Accor diversification. Digitalization has moved us towards what we call augmented hospitality. Through three layers. The first one is our core business, enriching the business of hospitality by acquiring new brands from 12 until 26, with a unique portfolio starting from rather mid-scale eco brands to now luxury brands and new recent acquisitions you saw like Burberry, Mantra, Mantis, and trust me, it's not gonna stop. Second layer is about taking acquisition. Because digitization process equals being able to leverage our digital capabilities. So this is relevant with the acquisition of Fastbooking, Avetro, Giko. Because digitalization is not only about consolidation, it's also about making sure we are taking enough. Last but not least, digitalization at Accor Hotel, back to the augmented hospitality ambition, is about delivering for the customers an enriched offer around a more global travel experience. Now you don't go to Accor just to have a stay in a hotel. You can enjoy F&B experience, Hotel Chabot, Rest Diary. You can enjoy co-working sessions next door. You can enjoy events, concerts with the acquisition of the Accor Hotel Arena. And maybe sometime in the future, you will enjoy travel on a train on the mythical Orient Express. So, digitalization equals diversification, but not only. What are the future challenges for Accor Hotels in 2018? I would summarize my digital ambition called Impact around five keywords. The first one is simplicity. Simplicity in all our services, tools, and experiences for the customers. Being a digital leader requests from us to be more simple, and this simplicity relies on two things, clarity and fluidity. If we take fluidity, it means fewer clicks, increasing our speed index, reducing downloading times. Clarity is about revamping our pricing architecture with fewer rates to make sure that our customers fully understand what they buy online. And the mix of fluidity and clarity leads us to a more simple experience online. We need to create for the customers, thanks to a true UX culture, an easier way to book online. And simplicity actually is not the easiest stuff to reach, right? Back to the famous quote of Leonardo da Vinci, simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. If you go one step further beyond simplicity, you have usage. Why usage? To me, usage is at the heart of our digital strategy. Usage, i.e., the capacity to meet, to really satisfy an unmet need of customers by creating a new service. Look at so many digital success stories. They all have one common point. They all met a need which was not satisfied. They created a service which was convenient, useful, smart, easy to use. When I was working for the French government, I remember very well the conflict on Uber. I remember I had one key lesson. Uber, at that moment, was at some point illegal, especially with Uber Pop. But you know what? No matter what, it was illegal with Uber Pop. People, consumers, kept on using it. And why did they keep on using it? Because usage was even stronger than law. So yes, digitalization is about the usage. And in Accor Hotels, our digital transformation relies on usage. How? We have been setting up the usage dogma through two KPIs. We are screening all our services, all the solutions we want to provide to the field through two KPIs. Is it used? Is it popular? If it's not, let's stop. Usage dogma is also about setting up new ways of working. We are systematically co-designing our solution, listening to the field. Testing through A/B tests, collecting real-time feedback from these users to make sure that we really meet the expectation instead of adding the impression to impose the right solution. On top of that, users is not the same everywhere in the world. Let's take this example of China. In China, over 3 seconds of speed index, you lose the people. Email is used, but not as much as WeChat ID. You have to also adapt your solution to new payment solutions. WeChat Pay, HPay, Alipay, UnionPay. We have to understand the behaviors of our customers to make sure we are really ready to welcome the Chinese travelers in China, but also in our 4,300 hotels. The third keyword on strategy about digitalization after simplicity and usage is about speed. And you're not going to be surprised about it, right? Speed meaning anticipate and accelerate. Anticipate because we need to keep on being connected to the trend of the market. what's going to come next, right? This is also why at Accor-Gel we are working a lot with startups, strategic players, also GAFA, we are creating partnerships. You must have seen that we have launched a partnership with Waze recently. We want to feel what's going to happen next tomorrow. A recent Gartner survey proved that by 2020, 75% of the American households are going to be equipped with vocal assistants, you know? This has to be anticipated. We in Accor-Gel are now currently developing a baby bot through machine learning. Of course, it's still a baby bot, but it has to become the future personal assistant of tomorrow for our guests. Because anticipation is not just about saying, we need to develop a bot able to answer. We need to develop a bot which, according to the data we would have collected on our people, would be able to proactively push our offers. So yes, digitalization is about anticipation, but also about acceleration. Digitalization for a digital native company is a matter of freedom. You have to go faster and faster. Not rushing your decision, but trust me, you have to go faster. Disruptors of tomorrow may be the disruptive of... Now, disruptors of today may be the disruptive of tomorrow. So you need to be able to anticipate and to accelerate your capacity to design and to deliver. The fourth keyword for me is a strong conviction also. It's personalization. I believe that personalization is going to be one of the key levers of differentiation for tomorrow. When I meet my loyalty members, the thing they tell me they love the most is to feel known and recognized in the hotels. Therefore, in 2018, in Accor-Gel, we have been launching a tool allowing our hotels to share all our customers' preferences, to tailor-make, to make sure we personalize at maximum their stay in the hotel. It's also about our capacity through data to be able to target the people we are talking to with a better and more relevant CRM strategy. It's also about loyalty. We are currently, accordingly to the augmented hospitality ambition, revamping our loyalty. Loyalty expectations have changed. People don't want to wait anymore. They want instant gratification. And people are not exclusive in loyalty programs. They are often belonging to several programs like a benchmark. So I want to enrich our loyalty offer to make sure we create habits and stickiness through an enriched experience at Apple. Last but not least, on personalization, I really think that a relevant personalization has to be responsible. I don't see the GDPR coming into force in less than 10 days as a constraint, but as an opportunity. I really think that our consumers will choose the companies which will respect their privacy and their data. To finish, I would like to tell you about culture. The digitalization process and strategy is for sure a techie ambition, a technological journey, but it's also a long-term cultural change. I have the mission, and we collectively, all together at Accor, we want to get into a constant learning company. By setting up a new governance, a new organization, new ways of working, MVP, sprints, feature team, shortening the decision-making processes, getting agile, not just in word, in action. Setting up the right to fail, the right to stop. This cultural ambition is a no-brainer. We need to be able to welcome matrix functions as mine, and to all become change agents. I call it T. T like breaking the silo, T like transversality, T like a bag of tea, because I need to infuse, I need to spread, I need this digital ambition to get everyone's challenge in the company. So yes, a non-digital native like Accor-Gel company can become digital. It has to become digital. It is actually a school of humility. card is demanding, it's sometimes exhausting. It has to rely on a solid cultural transformation too, but it's also a fantastic.